There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Just as you are before your God. Come.
One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now.
The time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Oh, come, just as you are to worship. Just as you are before your God. Come.
One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now.
worship you.
I worship
you. I worship you. You are here meeting every need. I worship you. I worship you.
Hallelujah.
You are here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. You're mending every broken heart.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus, the Son.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. You are here moving in our midst, working in this place. You are here mending broken hearts, touching lives. You are here turning lives around, healing every heart. You are here wiping away tears. You, Lord Jesus, you're the answer to it all. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. He is here. Receive what he has for you today. In the day that you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Hallelujah. Do not become insensitive to the moving of the Spirit. Hallelujah. Do not diminish it. Do not belittle it. He is here. And he is here for you. Hallelujah. 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 Open up your heart and receive what he has for you today. Glory to God. Receive what he has for you today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us, caring for us, keeping us, watching over us, fighting for us. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
We praise your name. We praise your name. Because if it wasn't for you, where would we be? Where can we go? Glory to God. We praise your name. And we say thank you. Going to slide right into communion. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to start off by talking, before we get to our verses, about the saints in Corinth. And I'm just going to summarize my first passage. But 1 Corinthians 11, 17 through 34 tells us that the Corinthians had a problem at the communion table. Glory to God. Apparently, there were some there who were rich and some who were poor. And Paul talks to them about this, because when they had communion, they also had a nice meal. And some would get there early, have their meal, get full, get drunk, and leave. And those that were poor, who had nothing to bring, would leave hungry. Came in hungry, leave out hungry. And Paul was telling them, this is not right. He said, when you do this, you are eating in an unworthy manner, and you're not discerning the Lord's body. You're not waiting for one another. You're not treating each other with respect and love. You are divided, and that ought not to be in the house of the Lord. So we're going to look at some scriptures. And these scriptures are going to tell us the meaning of the bread and the body. And this is what we're supposed to have on our minds when we come together to partake of the communion. We're going to start out in John 6th chapter, starting at verse 24. And just to give you a little background on these verses, Jesus had just fed the 5,000. And he and the disciples left that place, went back to Capernaum. So starting with verse 24, it says, when the people therefore saw that Jesus was not there, neither his disciples, they also took shipping and came to Capernaum, seeking for Jesus. 25. And when they had found him on the other side of the sea, they said unto him, Rabbi, when camest thou hither? How did you get here? We didn't know you were here. How did you get here? Jesus answered them and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, ye seek me not because you saw the miracles, but because you did eat of the loaves and were filled. Labor not for the meat which perish, but for that meat which endures unto everlasting life, which the Son of Man shall give unto you. For him have God the Father sealed. We're going to drop down to verse 33. For the bread of God is he which cometh down from heaven and gives life unto the world. Then said they unto him, Lord, evermore give us this bread. And Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. He that comes to me shall never hunger, and he that believes on me shall never thirst. Let's drop down to verse 48. I am that bread of life. Your fathers did eat manna in the wilderness and are dead. This is the bread which comes down from heaven, that a man may eat thereof and not die. I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man eat of this bread, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh, which I will give for the life of the world. The Jews therefore strove among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Then Jesus said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, except you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, ye have no life in you. Whoso eats my flesh and drinks my blood have eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He that eats my flesh and drinks my blood dwells in me, and I in him. As the living Father hath sent me, and I live by the Father, so he that eats me, even he shall live by me. This is that bread that came down from heaven, not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead. He that eats of this bread shall live forever. So when we come to the table, our thoughts ought to be on eating that bread, drinking that blood, so that we can live forever. Matthew 26. Matthew 26, starting at verse 26. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body. And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. 1 Peter 2:24. Who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree, that we being dead to sins should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. Amen. And our last scripture this morning, 1 Corinthians 10, 16. The cup of blessing, which we bless, is it not the communion of the blood of Christ? And the bread which we break, is it not the communion of the body of Christ? So when we come to partake, we come together as a community. There is unity in the community. So we come together as a community to take the communion and to be reminded of the Lord's death until he comes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Will the servers now come? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. So looking back at Matthew 26, verse 26. We see Jesus sitting here having the last Passover with his disciples, and then he institutes this Lord's Supper. And as they were eating, Jesus took the bread, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to the disciples. Lord, we thank you for what you did for us on Calvary's cross. Hallelujah. Let's break it. Take, eat. This is my body. Let's partake. Amen. He took the cup. He gave thanks, gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remissions of sins." So Jesus, thank you for your blood. Father, thank you for preparing Jesus to come and to be our sacrifice. We no longer have to take an animal to the priest and have it sacrificed. Jesus is the final sacrifice. And we thank you for the blood. Let's drink it. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Yes, God. Amen.
He was pure.
pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our sins. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wounds we are healed. He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our sins. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wounds we are healed. We are healed by your sacrifice and the life that you gave. We are healed. For you paid the price. By your grace we are saved. We are saved.
He was pierced for our transgressions. He crushed for our sins. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him.
And by his wounds, by his wounds we are healed. We are healed by your sacrifice and the life.
He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our sins. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wounds we are healed.
Away my sin, nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Hallelujah. By his wounds, we are healed. Hallelujah.
Well, praise the name of Jesus. Let's just continue just to worship the Lord. Thank you, Tammy, Pastor Reed, leading us this morning and leading us to the Holy of Holies. We said, our God is holy. I said, we serve a holy God. There's things happening in our bodies right now, in this body of believers this morning. There's manifested healing taking parts, and I'm receiving it myself. We believe. We believe. We believe, we receive. Lord, we believe. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to receive our tithes and offerings this morning. You're the same God that parted the seas. Is the same God that parted his arms and said, I will. I will, Father. I will be the sacrifice. Such a sacrifice. What an honor to be able to stand here and minister his word to you. When he saw me as a young child, caught up in such darkness. But we can all go back to our childhood before we knew Christ. I don't care where it is. We knew there was a God. We knew he was good. We couldn't understand. See, we couldn't understand the evil, the darkness, the things that was happening. But we knew God. We knew he was good. We just couldn't see. Our mind can't understand why bad things happen in a world when we were created so good. That same question is still being asked today, and that answer, the question hasn't been answered. Jesus. Jesus paid the price. He said, Father, I'll be the one. So as you get ready to give this morning, remember the special offering we took up a couple weeks for Marie Rivera. Her father has transitioned, and she had a great testimony how things, God gave some favor. And I said, listen, if God presses on your heart to do a special offering this Sunday, this is the last Sunday we'll receive that. We'll give you two Sundays to give. If the Lord purposes your heart to give, whatever it may be. See, that's what we do by faith. And God's already, see, our faith doesn't move God. God's already moved. He moved by grace. Our faith is getting in the flow, being a part, doing our part to help somebody else so God can flow that way. So if you want to give toward the Rivieras, toward Marie, and also we're going to pray in a minute because Angel's going to go in about 2 or 3 weeks, the third Sunday, he's going down for pre-op to take one of his kidneys and give to his father. Now, that's what we can do in the physical, but we're not giving up on God. That before, Angel's making that step of faith, but God can even in the midst of his step of faith create new kidneys for his dad, Angel. See, we don't give up, and you know, we do our part until. See, until Peter stepped out on the boat, he couldn't walk on water. And Jesus said, come, Peter. We heard, come. Well, Angel's going to come. Angel's going to go. But in the midst of that, we still believe that God is the one that still can create new kidneys. It causes me, and what can he do in our finances? If you'll turn, you ain't got to turn there. If you'll listen, in the book of Exodus, chapter 4. Let me get my notes. Hallelujah. Kelsey, if you put that picture up on the screen, some of you, a few of you in the church know this, of a treasure trunk. Treasure. There's a treasure trunk that was actually dropped off at our church this week in the parking lot. Somehow God going to work that in the message, but you know what? This was, Colette gave me a call. I forget what day it was, Colette. One day this week she called me and, Pastor, there's a trunk sitting out here. This is in where our lights are. You know, they ain't on the street. She sent me the picture and said, it's here. She said, I don't feel good about going up there. I said, no, I'll call the police department. We'll have them come check this thing out, you know. Make sure, right? We living in end times. And, but before Cabarrus County could get moving, it took about, I called our brother, called Ron, and he got on it for us. And, but then Colette, she didn't call me back, but I told her, I called her. I said, Ron's on the way, got some officers on the way. She said, oh, never mind, Pastor. Larry Honeycutt went up there, and he investigated. He said, there's nothing in there. He opened that old trunk, and it's just an old trunk. And so I called Ron. I said, Ron, I appreciate it. Thank you for moving. I said, but we got everything's taken care of. So my first thought when I saw that was concern, which like Colette, let's, you know. But then I got to thinking, before even Larry went and kicked it, I said, Lord, I know you. You know, there could be millions of dollars in that trunk. Because I'm just expecting big things from God, however he wants to do it. See, my next thing was expectation of how good God is. Now, see, he's not going to send money from heaven. He don't do that. It's in the earth. And as we were singing that song, Tammy, that song selection, it says, still the greatest treasure, say treasure. See, that's a treasure chest. See, the greatest treasure that remains is for those who choose him. Amen. So I said, Kelsey, give me that picture. There's something in that. There's something about that treasure that is him, Reed. He's the greatest treasure. Now, if there'd have been millions and billions of dollars, millions, oh, did I say billions too? Millions or billions of dollars, $1 million off and $1 billion flow. Hey, we can do big things, right? It takes money. But see, my expectancy was there. Because I told Colette, I said, it could have been, there was a neighbor down here that we blessed, and he blessed us, you know. I took him, he found my phone that got lost, and he brought it back to me. He picked it up off the road and didn't get crushed. And I took him a monetary gift and to thank him. And he was moving out, trying to give us things that we really, you know, he was being evicted. The guy was going to remodel the house down the street, so he was trying to get rid of some things, and we really didn't have, you know. I said, you need to sell these things and help yourself out. And I'm thinking, man, he might have left us a treasure and put some money. I don't know. I was just thinking, expecting. Hey, we need to be expecting big things from a big God. In Exodus 4, miracles. Miracles. Moses answered and said, God has called Moses, the pastor. Get my people out of that land. Get my people out from that enemy. See, your enemy might be the debtors or things that the devil stole from you. It might be debts and loans, or it might poverty or whatever it might be. See, God, we're supposed to be increasing. We're not supposed to be debtors. We're supposed to be the lenders, not the borrowers. That's the word. If we're not there yet, don't get under condemnation. Get under the blessing. Get blessed. Amen. Start expecting. Start speaking. That's how it works. I believe, Lord, and I speak. Moses had an issue with speaking. Come on. He didn't, but he did. Amen. Come on, we need some help sometime. Moses answered and said, but suppose they will not believe me or listen to my voice. Come on. My voice. Suppose they say the Lord has not appeared to you, Moses. So the Lord said to him, have you got your offering? Can you do it? Is it in your hand? Come on, everybody get the offering, put it in your hand. And my wife, if she's going to get whatever, by faith it's in my hand too. He said, the Lord said to him, what is that in your hand? Come on, look at this, guys. See, Moses had a shepherd's staff, a stick. It was to feed and protect the sheep. See, what do you have in your hand? See, this is our treasure. Jesus said, where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. See, this is our heart, man. When we give to God, that's our treasure, man. We love God. He doesn't need our money. He needs us. See, he was after his children. Moses, get my people. What's in your hand? What's in your hand today? I'm telling you by faith. Don't throw it on the ground when I say cast it. God told Moses, cast it on the ground. I'll tell you this, cast it upon the waters. For in many days, that's what the word says, cast it upon the waters, for in many days it'll come. You reap. When you sow, the Bible says, God said, I will not be mocked. Whatsoever you sow, you shall reap. But don't forget the promise, 30, 60, 100 fold. Jesus said that in this lifetime with persecutions. The 100 fold is limitless. But so is God. He's unlimitless. It's unlimitless. So don't get stuck on, don't be thinking 100 times. No, think $1 million in the trunk. Be expecting it. Be expecting those blessings. Cast it on the ground, and it became a serpent, and Moses fled from it. See, I used to not, I was a sinner. I didn't come to the house of God. I fled from people, Christians. Then the Lord said to Moses, now reach out your hand and pick it up by the tail. And he reached it out, his hand caught it, and it became a rod in his hand. See, it went from a stick to the rod of God. So see, what's in your hand today, whether it's 1, 5, 10, 100, 1,000, it becomes unlimitless in the kingdom. It can be enough to part the Red Sea. Miracles in our finances. Why? When we bring it into God's hand. Amen. When we feed missionaries, when we help. I just got a letter. Charlie and Kathy's coming the fifth Sunday. They're going to be in the States. We sent our tithe, Cindy. We released that tithe check to them of $1,000. He sent me a letter. Just got it today. Coming to church. I got to read it. Keep your hand out there. What's in your hand? Your hand made it to Thailand. It made it to Thailand. That's where they're from, the missionaries in Thailand. And he said, let me get it there. I had it. Boom, 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 boom. It's a done deal. Dear Pastor Robert, it's a done deal. We have water and plenty of it. Ain't that awesome? Two wells, say two. See, we like twos around here. Say yes to Jesus. Two wells have been successfully drilled and now produce an abundance of water. Both wells were drilled with a bit over 430 feet deep. He said, we hit a gusher. Amen. That's God. I said, that's God. See, we're a part of that. That excited me. It come just today. Say today. Today, Lord, we hear your voice. Let's stand. Stand with your gift in your hand. And we're casting it upon, we're putting it into the kingdom. Yes. What we hear this way, it's an everlasting kingdom that produces everlasting rewards. But not only in heaven, down here. Amen. Down here. So I'm expecting testimonies from you down here. Not next week, today. Amen. If it takes you next week to get it to me, that's fine. But just go ahead and if you want to send me a text message when you get it today, send it. Amen. So, Father, we thank you, Lord. Today, we choose to hear your voice and act upon your word. And we thank you, Father, for that return. And Angel and Marie, if you'll come down here right now. And, Father, we thank you, Lord, as we've set aside and we set aside money to give to this family, Lord, that they're a part of the family, that, Lord, we're expecting miracles, Lord. Lord, if Angel, he's already decided, he's already made a faith commitment. You know what, Lord, if it takes my kidney to help my father, to my physical dad live longer, so be it. But Lord, you are the God of the miracles, Lord, and we believe in miracles, Lord. And you can give Angel Senior right now two brand new kidneys, whatever he needs lacking, Lord. You are our shepherd, and we lack nothing. So Lord, we just release our faith today and agree with him. And speak blessings over them. He's already made the way. He's going to go. He's got to take off from work. He's got to do this. But Lord, he's not going to decrease. This family is not going to decrease. They're going to increase. And every family in this church is going to increase. In the mighty name of Jesus, can you say amen? So bring your tithes and offerings, worship the Lord, and release your faith with this family. Amen. Hallelujah.
And cry.
Hallelujah. Give me your hand, brother. What's in our hand? We stand hand in hand in the ministry, here to serve you as pastors, receiving from the Lord. We're not in competition. We're here to complete you. Amen. The plan of God, what He's got for us, what He's got for this church, what He's got for this community, this city. And we're not going to be empty-handed. Amen. We're going to be full of God's grace and power in our finances. We're going to be blessed in our finances. Father God, we thank you today. According to your word in Deuteronomy 6, 10 through 11, we're getting our lands and our places of employment. All of our debts are being eliminated, and we will owe no man nothing but to love one another. Today we claim our great and goodly cities, all of our houses full of good things, our vehicles and all the equipment and the people that we need to preach and teach the word of faith to the world, to make ready a people prepared for the Lord. Can you say amen? It's a holy thing unto the Lord. Amen. And it's about people. Moses, everything God called Moses to do before he was even formed in his mother's womb was about people. God's people. Amen. The Lord's people. Now, we're not all in the family, but we all are his created people. And everybody's got to make a choice. Today, if you hear his voice and make the choice to believe on his son Jesus, his first son, his only son. If you'll believe Jesus, if you'll just believe on him, believe on Jesus, that God sent Jesus to take away the sin of the whole world. If you'll believe on him and believe that he is God's son, he is who he said he was, and God raised him from the dead, the Bible says you'll be saved. Not tomorrow, today. You'll be saved from hell. You'll be saved from that separation, saved from darkness, outer darkness, that separated Adam and Eve in the beginning and separated the whole world, separated us from God until Jesus. Amen? Until Jesus. See, we're on the other side of the cross. Remember that? What's that song, Terry? It's on the other side. We're on the other side, man. We're on the victory side now. The sin debt's been paid for our healing, for our physical, for finances, everything that we need. The shepherd, Jesus, has paid the price. And I'm going to mention that our theme is still talking about God wants his people healthy, wealthy, full of his Holy Spirit and power. That was accomplished on Jesus, in Jesus. When John the Baptist baptized his cousin. Whew, man. He knew. John knew. John had a vision. God had showed John there's going to be one coming. And the one you see, the dove, come down and rest upon him, he's going to be he's the Messiah. He'll be the Lamb of God that will take away the sin of the entire world. John, his cousin, saw that and also saw Jesus, his cousin, raised up for 30-some years as a carpenter. He saw him in the flesh, but before he saw Jesus in the flesh, he saw him in the spirit. And John had to make a decision. Say decision. He had to believe what the Word of God said. I said he had to believe. We've never seen, yet we believe. Don't get hard on Thomas. Thomas doubted, but he saw Jesus, but he still wanted to believe. He said, unless I see, he didn't say, I'll never see. I'm talking about Thomas now. He said, unless I see, I won't believe. Thank God for his mercy. Jesus called, he's still one of the 12. And then Jesus came walking through a wall right there. I could see Thomas falling to his knees. He said, Thomas, here I am. Showed him, here's the scars. Put your finger here, thrust your hand into my side and be not doubting, but believing. Thomas didn't touch and he didn't thrust, but he believed. He said, Lord, I believe. He went from doubting to, now I believe. His name was changed. No longer was he doubting Thomas. He was Thomas. Amen. He was believing Thomas. And Jesus said, Thomas, because you believed. He said, but blessed, a greater blessing is upon those that never see yet believe. That's us. So I'm telling you, hang on to your confession of faith. Fight the good fight of faith. See, we're in the end times. There's going to be deceptions. Jesus even talked about times where even by the elect, they could except that he said, except I say by the elect, say they could even be deceived. Say, I'm not going to be one of them deceivers. I'm a believer. Amen. And we're going to hear faith, teach faith. We're going to operate in faith. We're going to see miracles by faith. See them in the natural too. Amen. Psalms 95. If you'll go there. Psalms 95. Let me get over here a minute. I'm going to focus on, because Reed preached last Sunday, and it just hit me in my spirit. It says today, that scripture in Hebrews 3, we'll get there. Hebrews 3:15 says today, and Tammy mentioned it this morning, today, if you'll hear his voice and harden not your heart. Talking about today, if we'll hear his voice. Now, he's going to use Robert Jackson, little boy from Mooresville, Southern twang, but he's also used your voice. You're born again, and it should be the voice of victory. 1 John 5:4. Once you get born again, Jesus has defeated death, hell, and the grave. Amen. He has conquered it, period. Dot, dot, dot. Put you a dot com. That means execution. He executed it, dot com. You know, WFWC.com, when you go there, when you hit that button, it executes a file. Amen. It takes you to that place. Jesus took us there. Jesus took us to heaven by him going, being the sacrifice on that cross. .com. He executed it. There's no other sacrifice that needs to be done. And we're focusing on your health. There's nothing we need to do other than believe on him. 1 Peter 2:24. The stripes that was put on his back, by his stripes we were healed. If Gary was here, he'd sing that little song. I am healed, I am whole, from the top of my head to the soles to the tip of my toes. 1 Peter 2:24 says, I was, if I was, then I am. I am healed, I am whole. Amen. Now, Gary Price is in heaven. Dr. Price is in heaven. Now, he went through a lot of stuff, but he still believed by faith. He recovered a lot of things by faith. And he would still say, fight the good fight of faith. Amen. Until you depart and get out of here. Amen. Whether it be by the rapture or by the grave. Either way, we going one way. Amen. To see Jesus. He's coming sooner than we think. Psalms 95. Today, if you'll hear his voice. David said, come, let us sing to the Lord. We've been singing. Amen. We've been praising the Lord. Let us shout joyfully. If you ain't shouted, go ahead and shout right now. Amen. Joyfully to the rock of our salvation. I tell you what, Miss Sherri, she was writing little words on some rocks last night in my living room floor. Me and Kelsey are sitting there. All them rocks, they disappeared where they ended up at my house. She's saying, somebody speak the word. And Kelsey's speaking it, Sherri writing it on them rocks. Don't let them rocks get your praise. You praise the Lord. Amen. Now, them rocks, she's put some word on there for us to read. But see, back in the Old Testament, when you'd have a victory, they'd take rocks and put up rocks for a memorial. It was putting up Jesus, man, putting up the rock. I'm here because of the rock. I'm going to remember this victory, amen? So we need to remember our past victories, but to sling them at what's before us right now. Amen? The rock of my salvation. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving. And I'm thankful. Kelsey's been, they've let me know, and Kelsey was telling me they pretty much was going to get some tickets for that ball game. I did not know the church was wanting that. Thank you. That just blessed me. Amen. Thank you. Now I'm going to, now this dream I thought was for an appointed time. This is it, ain't it, Terry? I just need to go ahead and tell you the dream because that just hit my heart. Well, I don't know. It might have been a month, 2 months ago. I spoke from the pulpit at one time, be giants for Jesus. I don't know if some of you heard that. Kelsey heard it, wrote it down. Well, they're working on a little plan. So they wrote that on a piece of paper last night, giants for Jesus. So I went to bed. I had a dream. Now, just take this like a grain of salt here, but I dreamed I was on the Giants team, Kerry. I was training. I was in the camp, man. We were training. I was on the New York Giants team. I don't know what position I played, but I was playing. And I mean, it was tough. It was tough training. And I think the next place we were loading up on the bus and we're going, and I think we're going to Dallas. Because I got on that bus and I'm looking at all these New York Giants and I'm dressed up in the uniform. And I'm looking at them and I say, guys, I love you. I love you. I'm glad to be on this team. But I tell you, we're going to the Cowboys and that's my first love. Even though I'm on the Giants, I love the Cowboys. Scripture and verse, Pastor. Jesus said, don't forget your first love. That's the scripture that came to me, Terry. See, Jesus is my first love. Now, I love the Cowboys. I'm going to be blessed at that game, but I tell you what, if Jesus comes 2 minutes before, take me, Jesus, I'm ready to go. Amen. See, he's my first love. Amen. See, Cowboys are not before Jesus, but they are before the Giants. But even if I'm playing on their team, see, a lot of people switch teams. Now, they're playing the Panthers. You know what side? The tickets need to be on the Cowboys side, not the Panthers side. But that's your home team. No, it ain't. Cowboys. But I'm a Cowboys fan before North Carolina decided we're going to have a Panthers team. And a lot of my buddies and friends, the Cowboys, they switched over. Now, Panthers are number one. I'm saying, you heathens. They jump ship. Panthers is your home team now? No, my first love is the Cowboys. Whether we got Panthers, that's my team. Some of you might shout and not, but I'll get you a shout back here in a minute. But thank you, church. Thank you. That really blessed me. Amen. And I wish it was the old Aikman team. That's the team me and Mama, that was our team. That was like the A team for the Cowboys back then. Troy Aikman, Tony Dorsett, them boys. I know it wasn't Dorsett, it was Eric. My God. See, y'all know I ain't kept up football a lot. He was the next best to Tony Dorsett. He was, it'll come in a little bit. No, it was a running back. Terry will get it. See, we in the Word, though. Come on, we got to get back to the Word. I done got off that path. My mind's really battling the Word right now because it's trying to remember that running back. Emmett Smith. Thank you, Kerry. That was the Emmett Smith, Troy Aikman, y'all know. But see, now it's our time. It's their time now. See, that was the older team. They had their time. Well, see, the older saints, they had their time to preach the gospel. Now it's our time. Come on. Amen. We're going to hear his voice today, and we're going to shout his voice to the housetop. It's our time to tell Jesus is still Lord. Amen. Jesus is king in a perverse and wicked generation. He's still healing today. He's still saving today. He's still blessing. He's still bringing us out of poverty today. Amen. Amen? We're going to shout for the home team. Jesus is the home team. See, let us shout joyfully to him with psalms. For the Lord is the great God and the great King above all gods. In his hands, are the deep places. See, me and Reed, we hooked hands today, but you know what? We took hands together as we hold hands together with God. God holds the deep places. There's deep things in people that's got to get rooted out. Trees of racism, trees of all kind of things that's been spoken against people that we're going to root it out. Amen. See, I don't see color. I see spirits in this place. And see, that's what Christians got to see. See, Jesus, he didn't bring denominationalism. He brought Christians. He made Christians. Amen. Because denominations brought divisions. Well, we the speaking in tongues crowd, or we don't be believing in speaking in tongues. Well, you know what? It's not, we on the Jesus team.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to love them regardless. Amen. Because we don't have to come in the unity of the doctrines and the unity of the faith in believing in Jesus. Now, we got a foundation of doctrine. Don't get me wrong. But see, we got to stay united in the spirit of the faith. Amen. Unity. Believing on Jesus. Amen. And I don't know why I brought this little pepper up here. My wife's not in here, is she? Because when you come to Word of Faith Worship Center, if you get here about 9:30, we got coffee. I didn't eat them things. They called nutty bars. it's like some of these words are leaving me this morning. Nutty bars. We got wafers over there. And sometimes we even have green bell peppers. Cayenne peppers. But I don't eat them. I'm just letting you know, you come to Word of Faith Worship Center, we got all kinds of things in this church. Amen. But the main thing is the Word of God.
Amen.
Amen. I don't eat peppers. But you might like peppers. Amen. But we all love Jesus, right? He gave us peppers, apples, oranges. I don't eat all the things he created, but there's some things. Colette's banana pudding. I really like banana pudding. You know, we ate at Lancaster's last night, and we left, me and Kelsey and Sherri, and we were full. But you know what? I said, man, I could have ordered some banana pudding. I really miss that banana pudding. But I really, really like Colette's banana pudding. But anyway, just to let you know, we love Jesus here. And we bring things home to share with each other. Peppers, you name it. Sometimes it shows up in the kitchen. Amen. Bacon. We cook bacon around here. I like bacon. Verse 6, let us worship and bow down. Let us see, fellowship is part of worship. Come on. They went, the first church, when they got born again, they went about teaching the doctrine, breaking bread from house to house, having fellowship. Amen. See, that's what it's about. It's about bringing Lumbee Indians in him, getting them full of the Holy Ghost and power.
Amen.
Having Jack might start a powwow group in this place. But what he's going to, well, who's he going to lift up? He ain't going to lift up his tribe. He's going to lift up Jesus.
Amen.
Because he is the tribe of Judah. Come on. Amen. Hallelujah. And we know how to roar for Jesus. See, we're not going to judge people. We're going to love people. Amen. And bring them to Jesus. That's what David says. God, he's a great God. He's king above all. He has the deep places on the earth in his hands. Verse 4, the heights of the hills are his also. Verse 5, the sea is his. Talking about God. For he made it and his hands formed a dry land. He is our God. Say, he's my God.
He's my
shepherd. 23:4. And we shall not fear, for he is with us.
Amen.
Let's go worship him and bow down before him. We are his people and of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you'll hear his voice. Amen. Every day God is speaking. If you'll hear his voice, don't harden your hearts as in the rebellion. They're talking about when they rebelled against God's voice. And in the day of trial in the wilderness, when your fathers tested me, they tried me, though they saw his work. Come on. Some saw that vision. John had a vision. This is the Lamb of God that take away the sins of the world. And the children of Israel saw manna from heaven. For 40 years it rained manna consistently. For 40 years. The rock. There was water that came in the desert. That water was Christ. For 40 years, they saw my work, and I was grieved with that generation and said, it is a people who go astray, where? In their hearts. They go astray in their hearts, and they do not know my ways. So I swore, God had to swear in his wrath, that they will not enter my rest. Now, that grieved him. For 40 years, it grieved him. I'm thinking it was a four-day trip to the promised land. But they wouldn't believe. Hebrews chapter 3. Today, if you hear his voice. Let's say, today, we're going to hear his voice. We've already heard his voice. And we're going to keep faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. The Word of God never gets stale. I tell you what, that communion element we took one day, you know, if you leave that thing in outside for 3 or 4 years, that bread is going in there, it's going to get stale. But see, that's just physical bread. But the Word of God, Jesus, He's the living bread. And his Word, he's alive, and He never gets stale. Amen. His Word, it can speak to you. I said, it speaks. Well, I've read that scripture before. Read it again. Be obedient. What's the Lord, what's He saying to you today? Hebrews 3, chapter 3. Paul speaking here says, therefore, here's Paul, the Apostle Paul, speaking to the saints. Speaking to these Hebrews. Holy brethren, partakers of the heavenly calling, consider the apostle and high priest of our confession, Christ Jesus. Remember, he put Christ first, the anointed one, the Messiah, Christ Jesus, who was faithful to him who appointed him, as Moses also was faithful in all his house. For this one has been counted worthy of more glory than Moses, insomuch as he who built the house has more honor than the house. Come on, Jesus is God. For every house is built by someone, but he who built all things is God. You know, Larry and Frankie, a lot of other people built this house with their hands, physical hands. This house, this temple, this church you're sitting in, they were here, they sweated and they built this house. But God built them. Had God not built them, they couldn't have built this house. So I thank God for Larry and Frankie, and I thank them for this house, but I thank God for them. Amen. For sending them, for them being obedient to come to this place and build this place so that we come worship in this place. And I tell you what, God's building you a house too, brothers and sisters. He and me too. Mansions. Amen. Plural. He's building us houses. There's some down here too being built in Jesus' name. For every house is built by someone, but he who builds all things is God. And Moses indeed was faithful in all his house as a servant. See, we're no longer servants. We're sons that serve. Amen? Amen. We're sons and daughters that serve. See, back then they were servants. Jesus gave us a better covenant. Amen? Yeah. A better covenant. Moses was a servant for a testimony of those things which would be spoken afterwards. But Christ as a son over his own house, whose house we are, if we what? Hold fast the confidence and the rejoicing of hope firm to the end. See, we're in the end times and we're going to hold fast because we're going to hear his voice not only in this house, but in this house when we leave this building. Amen? Because see, this building is not the church. We're the church. And his voice, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, goes with us. Amen. Wherever we go, whether we go to Texas or whether we go to North Carolina, God goes where we goes. Amen. Amen. Remember the Old Testament, they moved that tabernacle. They didn't go till the word went. Amen. When they picked up, when those Levites picked up the Holy of Holies, they picked up that tent of tabernacle. When it moved, what? They moved. When the Holy Ghost moves, what do? We move. Amen. Come on, we got to let the Holy Ghost move in the church again. Amen. Well, Pastor, what are you doing? I ain't moving until he moves. Amen. We ain't dismissing until he says dismiss, right? But then that's when it gets started, brothers and sisters, because that's when you go out here by faith. Amen. We walk by faith. When you hear the message, what do? You get out here and walk it out by faith. And the Holy Ghost moves in you, working in us, among us, to manifest his glory. Amen. The glory, the miracles, the healings in us, among us. Hallelujah. We need, there's coming a time, you know, we're going to get our stuff. We got our stuff. It's going to manifest and we're going to take it to others. See, as we walk in, things are manifesting in Jesus' name. Today, some things are manifesting in Jesus' name. Amen. I ain't trying to feel it if it happened. I know it happened. Come on. I know it happened. I'm talking about healing. I'm quit trying to feel it. I know it. And I'm going to sing about it. I don't care what the doctor sees. He don't know who's in me sometimes. They can't see God. Yeah, they can. They'll see it. They'll see it on their instruments. But David played his until he saw it. Amen. He never saw heaven. You know, David lost that son. He didn't lose it. He lost him here, but he gained him there. David said, I can't get him back here, but I'm going there. I'm going to see my son, the one that was lost. Amen. Hallelujah. We've got some loved ones that's departed. We're going to see them again.
Amen.
We're going to see them again. We have the hope of the resurrection. Hallelujah. Where'd I get? I lost my place. What verse am I on? 7. Be faithful. That's my subtitle. Be faithful. In season, out of season. When it looks like it's working or it don't look, be faithful. Because we're not moved by feelings. We're moved by the Word of God. What has Jesus said? Therefore, as the Holy Ghost, say the Holy Ghost. He speaks too. He's got a voice. Sometimes it's like a small, still voice. But it sounds big in my brain. My brain's like, surely I can't do it. Surely there can't be millions of dollars in that treasure trunk outside. But my mind is trying to ration it away. But I'm like, I don't know. I want to make sure those cops. I'm like, maybe I need to get with Colette. Let her be standing close. Just in case money comes flying out of things, the cops don't take our money and run. We need a witness there, right, Reed? Because I started thinking. See, first of all, I'm thinking about what bad things it could be. But I'm like, well, we serve a good God. A miracle-working God is out to bless us. To build buildings, we got to have money. To go on TV, it's going to take money. So I'm looking for money in God's places. Amen. It might come in trunks. I don't care. I was looking for, when they was digging up this big line to put that electro, I was looking for gold to come up out of the ground, expecting.
Amen.
I'm just looking, expecting. I'm like Abraham. I'm just looking for that city. Lord, you said, look, go, be expecting, be looking. And he got blessed. It got God made him not rich. He made Abraham very rich because Abraham kept looking for that city. Well, he's there. I said, Abraham's there. But guess what? The city's coming down here. Jerusalem's, that holy city's coming down from heaven, down here. See, that's why he was looking, because he knew it was coming down here sometime, didn't he, Reed? Because God said it. And if God said it, that settles it.
Amen.
Amen. I don't care what CNN says. Or Fox says, come on, or what the doctor says, or what the banker says, what has God says.
Amen.
See, I don't give at church depending on what's that street, Wall Street's doing. I'm not up and down. We're not up and down. We're not yo-yo Christians, right? We're not yo-yos. We go ye. We go-goes. Go ye into all the world. What? And preach this good news. You don't have to be poor. You don't have to be sick no more. Jesus is your healer. He's your provider. He's El Shaddai, not El Cheapo. Amen. And I keep giving because he keeps giving. When I give, he just gives more. And he got more in store. Amen. And faith is the key that unlocks the door. Amen. My what? My faith in God. Faith in his word, faith in his voice, faith in his promises. This is the victory, amen, that overcomes the world, even our faith in God. So today, if you'll hear his voice, David's saying the same thing, Paul's saying the same thing David said, if you'll hear his voice, and what? Harden not your heart. See, a lot of Christians go to church, hear the good, rich word of God, but they don't believe it. And every time you don't believe, it hardens your spiritual heart to receive the incorruptible seed. See, it ain't the seed's the problem, it's the heart's the problem. And God says, it takes faith to please me. And if I get in doubt, I'm not pleasing God, and he can't get his word into my heart, so it'll produce a harvest. And sometimes it's words that we don't even want it to get in my head. But see, it ain't your head the problem, the heart's the problem. If it get in your head, you can cast them out. But if it get in your heart, then you got to root them out. I said, you got to root them out when they get down there. That means you got to keep confessing and keep until what you finally get that tree out of there. Now you got room for more good seed to get in. See, sometimes we got trees in us that we got to get out. Trees that daddy and mama planted, that this world planted in us because we didn't have God in us. See, if you don't have God in you, there's the devil, unbelief's coming in. Come on. Hallelujah. But thank God, Jesus is our hope Don't harden your hearts. Hear his voice. Don't harden your heart as a rebellion in the day of trial in the wilderness where your fathers tested me, tried me, saw my works for 40 years. Therefore, I was angry with that generation and said, they always go astray in their heart and have not known my ways. So I swore my wrath, they shall not enter my rest. Paul is saying the same thing David said. And we got to say the same thing. See, a lot of times people are asking questions, and the answers, they don't want to hear the answers we're going to give them. But keep giving them the right answer, the truth. Because it's the truth that's going to set them free, not your tickling, not giving them something that's going to please their ears. Give them light. Amen. Don't agree with the darkness. Give them light and revelation. See, the light's going to help them get out of the darkness. Beware, brethren, lest there be an end. Now, Paul is talking to the Christians. So I'm talking to the saints today. Beware. I'm saying beware. I'm not telling you to be in fear. I'm not telling you to be in fear. I'm telling you to beware. I'm not telling you. You don't have a spirit of fear. It tries to get in there, but you got to stay out of fear and stay in faith. He's saying, beware, brethren, lest there be in any of you an evil heart, what of unbelief. See, that's what, it's not so much the, it's an evil, not people, it's the unbelief that people believe. They don't believe God. If they don't believe God, they're believing evil stuff. And listen, guys, some of them don't, I didn't know these things. I didn't know I was full of all this unbelief, evil stuff. It was just natural unbelief coming in there that, you know, that if you don't have God, you just have him, what the world has to offer, which is fear. Amen. But we don't have that spirit no more. Once you get born again. So what do we do when we come to church? We exhort one another daily while it's called what? Today. We're not going to talk about the devil a lot. We're not going to give him. We're going to talk about God. We're going to talk about Jesus. See, a lot of people, sometimes that's the problem. A lot of church people, they focus too much on what the devil's doing instead of what God has done. We give the devil too much place. See, this ain't, we're not here to give the devil glory. We're here to give God glory. And how does God get glory? By healing us and by saving us and by cleansing us and washing us and giving us a sound mind and touching our children's children, generations. Amen? That's what brings glory to God. Exhort one another, verse 14, for we have become partakers of Christ if we hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast to the end. We're not yo-yo Christians. We're not up one day and down the next. If you yo-yo, stay here long enough, we'll cut that string and set you free. Amen. Come on, we'll cut that string of doubt, unbelief. You stay here long enough. I said, you stay here long enough, the word will find out what's causing the problem. Amen. And I'm preaching to myself. I don't understand everything, but if I just keep putting the word in, I won't have to understand it. I'll have revelation and I'll know what to say. I'll know what to do. Amen? You'll have a word in due season. He'll say, do this or do that. Amen? And it don't have to be King James. You'll just have a knowing to do something. While it is said today, if you hear his voice and do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion. See, this is what happened in the wilderness. For who having heard, they rebelled. Indeed, was it not all who came out of Egypt led by Moses? If you go back and read that, out of all those million, come on, we're talking big numbers here, millions of people. See, don't think you're going to get rich hitting the lottery. There was a lot of big numbers. There's one that's going to hit it, but majority, it's not going to be you. I'm just telling you the odds. Just like all those people, all God's people that came out of Egypt, millions of people, two made it to the promised land. Two, why? They had a spirit of faith, not a spirit of the world. They believed Moses. They believed God, and they had a spirit of faith. And they made it to the promised land. Now, when I say they, two of the adults, now the children born out there, they got to go in, but not that crowd, the adults that came out of Egypt that rebelled against God. And what is this manna? What is this manna? Complained and murmured. Snakes bit them in the wilderness. They fell dead out there. Why? Bickering and complaining. We got to trust God. We got to hear his word. Amen. And act on it. That's what's going to get us free. Today, if you'll hear God's voice concerning healing. Now, I haven't preached a lot yet on healing. What am I doing? I'm getting you ready. I'm priming your pump. Amen. We're getting foundations built. Because What Miss Sherri taught up here to them kids, she taught about a foundation. You can have yours built on a rock, or you can build it on the sand. The sand is the world. The rock is Christ. And if you'll put your foundation on Christ, I don't care what the doctor says, what the banker says, what anybody says, what has God said? And he says, you're going to the other side, Pastor Jackson. You're going to take my word to the world. You're going to build buildings. You're going to go on TV. Your word, your voice. He said, your voice shall be a bigger influence to the world. What? The voice of victory. The voice of faith. That's what people need to hear. Because they're hearing, there's all kind of voices out there speaking to you. Amen? All kind of voices. A lot of them you can control, but a lot of them you can't. But you can control your voice, what you say. Because see, I'm not living by what they say. I'm living what I say, by what the fruit. I'm living by what I have said in the past. So you want to change your past? You want to change your past? Well, don't worry about the past. You want to change your future? Start sowing today. Amen? It matters what you say today. And remember, when tomorrow never comes, because once it gets here, it's today. Amen? So you can change your future today. Hallelujah? Amen. We're going to hear his voice. Hebrews 11:6, as we close down here, says, but without, no, wait a minute. Today, if you hear God's voice concerning healing, we heard it this morning, 1 Peter 2:24. Bring that scripture back up before my eyes, Kelsey. 1 Peter 2:24. I know the gist of it, but I want to see it in my eyes. Who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree. We're talking about trees. That we, being dead to sins, should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes you were healed. When sickness is battling you, that's what you got to speak. That's the victory. That's the voice you got to hear. You got to hear that voice, but you can't just hear it. You got to speak it. You got to hear it and keep hearing it, get down in your heart. Next thing you know, when it comes out your mouth, that means it's yours. You've got it. I don't have to think about it. This is, uh-uh. By his stripes, I was healed. So you don't have to know a lot of scripture. Just know Jesus said that. And when I say Jesus did that, he accomplished that, and Peter said it. Amen. Hey, Peter said a lot of things not right at one time. But the Holy Ghost, if you'll hear his voice, the Holy Ghost is saying today. See, that same Holy Spirit that was with Peter is in us. Amen. Wherever we go.
Thank you, Lord.
I said, wherever we go. I tell you what, we can be right in the middle of pregame, Giants and the Dallas Cowboys. It'd be loud, noisy out there, because it gets noisy in them stadiums. But I tell you what, we can hear God's voice right in the middle of it.
That's right.
And if he says, get up and get out, you know what? We're going to leave, right? Because I love Jesus more than, and I'll give me a mic. If God says get out, that means destruction's coming. I want everybody to get out. Amen. Fire, get out. Get out. You don't have to question why. There's a fire.
Yes.
So see, we're out to save men's lives. Amen. And we're going to hear God's voice concerning healing. And doubt it not. Don't doubt what you just read and heard and spoke. Believe only, and we will enter into that rest.
Thank you, Lord.
The rest. The rest of faith. And the just shall live by faith. There is a rest. There's a rest we can get into where no matter what, even the pain, we can get into a rest where, you know what? God, you said it, and I believe it. I got it. And just rest in that faith, and the pain will have to leave. Sickness will have to leave. Amen?
Amen.
And it's a fight. It's a fight of faith. Jesus can't fight that fight for us. Jesus paid everything for us, but it's a fight that we got to fight with our words. Fight those thoughts with his words, the words of victory. And there's 66 books in the Bible that's full of words of battles being fought, battles being won, battles being lost. And a lot of times you'll see the battles that was lost is because there was sin in the camp. There was unbelief in the camp. There's giants in the land. But we as grasshoppers, see, that's where they lost it. They lost it by what they saw. Not the giants, it's who they saw themselves being. Well, Robert, you're not that smart of a man. I mean, you graduated, but you wasn't the top of your class. What do you think you can look at people and tell them that they're healed? See, this is the devil. This is the way he talks. Who are you? You know, your daddy, you know, he wasn't even around in your life, and he said you were an accident. See, these are things that this is what the devil did, and that he wants to remind you of your past. Well, that's when you just tell him, devil. When he's talking about diabetes and high blood pressure, you know what I'm going to start doing, Cecil? I'm going to turn around and say, devil, look. You see Jesus back here? You see those stripes on his back? By his stripes, I'm healed. And I'm going to go to bed. Amen. I'm going to go to sleep. I'm going to rest. Amen. Because it's not by my works. It's by grace. It's by God's grace. By his power. And you don't have to be loud. You just need to be faithful. I got it. Don't change it. That's who I am. Period. Because without faith, it's impossible. But see what? We're not going to be without faith. God determined, I'm not going to be without faith. Because Jesus is never without faith. And if he's in me, he said he'll never leave me. That means faith is always there. But faith is not of the head, it's of the heart. So that's where our battle is. The devil wants to see. The devil will beat us every time in our head. And if he beats us in our head, our body operates by things going on in our head, right? Not by your brain. Come on. People be like, well, I ain't too smart. Well, see, the flesh up there, that's your brain. Your mind is different. You have to say, I have the mind. Say, I have the mind of Christ. You get in the Word, he gives you his thoughts. Amen. Jesus will give you his thoughts. And his thoughts are higher than my thoughts. His thought says, believe me, for billions, millions and billions, not nickels and quarters. Come on, we got to go from nickel and quarter faith to $1 million faith, $1 billion faith. Amen. Amen. I mean, there's no problem. It's in the earth. Those amounts are in the earth. So why should we see us down here when God sees us up here? One word from God, one idea from God. You could be the Jeff Bezos. You could be the Elon Musk. God created them. He created the house. It's his house. Without God's wisdom, they can't think of those things. Even though they might not be serving him, God's still going to give them the idea because he chose to. Now, whether they choose to serve him or not, that's up to them. But, you know, it would be better if they serve God, because who wants to be the richest man that goes to hell? You might have a name here in the earth, but if your name's not in the Lamb's Book of Life, you don't have a name in heaven. But why don't you just have it all? Amen. I'd like to get on one of those rockets and go to the moon. Amen. Now, I'd really have to pray about that, because that costs a lot of money. And if I got that money and I got a chance to go to the moon or do something, I'm going to make sure that's a lot of money. When they start talking about tickets where they want to send me to the ball game, Kelsey will be truthful. When she said like $1,000, I'm like, that's a lot of money for a ticket. I ain't never paid that. So I'm like, no, I don't spend that kind of money. Now, y'all just listen to the Lord. I'm just saying, you know what I mean? I still got a brain that I use. I love the Cowboys, but $1,000, less, you know, that's a lot of money. Come on. That's a lot of money. Amen. But that's where, hey, let the Lord lead you. But see, he's not looking. See, that's where I got to get my mind off of numbers. Because God, to $1,000, that's like a penny to him. Come on. The one who owns the cattle and the hills. See, money's not the problem. It's the love of money. That's the problem. But God's got a solution. Just love him. Amen. Just love him, and when the money comes, you won't have a problem. Say amen. Amen. Don't have a problem with the money coming. Because God knows if you love him, the money will come in. It'll go where he tells you to go. You'll send it. You'll do this. You'll do that. And he gets all the glory. You know, I heard stories, and these are true stories. I mean, I wasn't there, but hear stories of God blessing people and their church. And they went out and bought them what's one of the high-dollar cars? Like, it's not a Mercedes anymore. Like, what's some high-dollar one? No, higher than that. Higher than that. Higher than that. I don't know what name of it, but them pretty high cars too, but... Y'all know, y'all been looking at cars, ain't you? But he got one of them. It was one of them nice ones. But he parked it out back. Because he was a figure people would get offended that he would have something that nice to drive to church. See, that's wrong thinking. I get something like that, I'm going to put God's name all over it. It's going to sit up front. It's going to have a tag talking about Jesus. Say yes to Jesus. Why? That's going to bring glory. A little moped we used to drive, Jack? You think that don't, you know what I mean? And God, don't get into condemnation. We're not there anymore, are we? It's your time you was giving glory to God on that moped, because before then you might have been walking. But see, God has a bigger place for us. See, be content where you are, but that ain't where I'm staying. Amen? Because God, what desire is he giving you? You might not have a desire to go to the moon. You might not have a desire to go watch the Cowboys play. But do you have a desire to love Jesus and to bless somebody else that might want to do that? See, that's giving God glory. When you can take something and you got things you want to do, but take somebody and bless somebody else, that's Jesus. And when Jesus sees you do that, you know what? He bringing you something big. So get ready to receive it. Amen. Hallelujah. I think we're gonna try to unhook right there. And next Sunday, that's next week, we'll talk about hear and be healed. Second Sunday. Now, thank you for bringing his name up, because he needs prayer. Now, I'm not saying Jim won't minister next Sunday, but he took a fall 2 days ago, and he called me, texted and called me. Going to Bojangles, get him and Wanda some breakfast. He heard something, and he turned, and when he stumbled and fell and cracked two ribs. So he's in some pain, but he's by his wounds, Dr. Price is healed. Dr. Price, Dr. Howard is healed. Dr. Price is healed too. He's just agreeing right now. He's agreeing with Jim. He's healed too. Amen. Dr. Price says, amen. That's a good message. He would say, did you get anything out of this? So, Father, in the name of Jesus, let's just do. Oh, my goodness.
She's got black eyes and bumped up, big knot on her head.
So here's another person God's going to touch right now, already touched. By your wounds, we call Amanda healed. We call Dr. Howard healed, Lord. Yes. Lord, we know there's a healing process that takes place when our bones are cracked. But, Lord, you can supersede it. Lord, we believe in the God of supernatural abilities. That, Lord, we don't have to live on the low ground. We can live on the high ground. That Jim can be healed today. I said those ribs can be touched and mended today, because you're the God of the breakthrough. And, Lord, it's not your will that we fall and stumble. And we thank you, Lord, when we do, that we shall arise. We thank you, Lord, that Jim arises and Amanda arises right now, because there's healing in your wings. There's healing in your word. And, Father, we just speak that to Dr. Howard right now, Lord, that he receives that. That he receives it and he rests, Lord. We rest in faith that Amanda and Jim receiving that right now. And we thank you for that, Father, in Jesus' name. Anybody else got a prayer request? Need the Lord to do something.
Praise report.
We take praise report and prayer request at Word of Faith Worship Center.
My sister-in-law that I went to visit and help out, she is totally healed up and around. And she was out driving yesterday.
Hallelujah.
She's traveling the end of the month.
Glory to God.
Yes, praise God.
What's her name?
Patty.
But
was there in MD Anderson Hospital. I got a chance to talk to some people and pray for them.
Hallelujah.
And there's some people in bad shape.
Taking light to darkness, Terry.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Lord, everybody that Terry talked to, Lord, and all that, and we just agree with that faith. Lord, help them receive, Lord. Help them to hear that voice. That's the voice that Terry, the voice of victory that he brought.
Yes.
And we thank you, Lord, for this testimony. But, Lord, there's others out there that have the moanies, Lord. They're going through tests. And they need the victory. And we thank you, Lord, for Terry planting seeds of victory right now, Lord. And we water those seeds right now with our faith and agree, Lord, that you put perfect labors across their path, that they'll keep hearing good word. They'll hear the word, the good word of faith, that seed will come up out of the ground, Lord, Terry, 100-fold. Lord, that sickness will have to leave and healing will manifest. And we give you the praise for that in Jesus' name. See, all it takes is one person with a seed of faith. Drive with light to drive out darkness. See, it don't take a lot of light to drive out darkness. It don't Jesus said, you are the light. He's the light. See, without him, we couldn't be lit. But then he said, now you're the light of the world. So, amen, we got some light. Yes. You can't, let me get, I'll tell you what, I'll stand close to you, Kelsey, get it.
I just want to say that, you know, the Bible talks about building ourselves up, mm-hmm. his most holy faith. And so, you know, I sing a lot around the house and all, but this is a song I've been singing lately.
Sing it.
I'm so blessed, got this heartbeat in my chest, it doesn't matter about the rest. If I got you, Lord, I'm so blessed.
Yes.
And I sing that yes. all the time.
Yes.
And I feel like his Holy Spirit. And, you know, if we can just be thankful
yes,
for
Lord.
Things that he does for us every day, the breath we breathe, yes. mm-hmm. getting up in the morning,
yes.
we are so blessed.
Yes.
And we need
Amen.
To remind ourselves,
Amen.
I'm so blessed, I'm so blessed. Got this heartbeat in my chest. It doesn't matter about the rest. If I have you, Lord, I'm so blessed.
Hallelujah. What is that? That treasure chest. That treasure is him. It's all about him. We got him. We need to know that we got him. And if he's got, we got him, he's got us.
Yes.
But then we need to take him to the world. Amen.
Yes.
And just like Terry, just like just taking that simple promise. Like I was telling Kelsey, there's people, like Leo was sharing, there's people that have never been prayed for. It's kind of like we take things for granted sometimes because we hear the word. We believe, we confess. Man, we're word giants. We're giants for Jesus. Amen? But there's a lot of grasshoppers out there, a lot of Christians that think they're just grasshoppers. They're just waiting for the world to step on them and crush them. When the devil, Jesus crushed the devil under his feet. Amen. So we just need to see ourselves as giants for Jesus and go out there and crush principalities and power. Amen. It's not doing this great warfare. It's going out and being the church, saying a prayer, laying hands on the sick. Amen.
A friend of mine, Marine Corps, buddies of mine, he have kidney stones. And they got him scheduled for the 4th of this month to see if they can break a blood himself. But he saying that a week ago they went for emergency surgery, but they couldn't do it because its kidneys was failing because they're so large and everything was just shut down. But they gave medicine and stuff and went in for the effort with the pain in the kidneys and stuff. So they got scheduled for October 4th to see could they recommend that they not pass. So it's standing in agreement that they will.
Amen. What's his name?
Esau Brown.
Stand up, brother. When you stand up, the kidneys leave. Come on, when you stand up, this is your brother. We're agreeing. Speak the word of faith over his name right now. Come on, church. Kidney stones got to go.
Thank you, oh God, right now, in the name of Jesus, because by the stripes of Jesus, he was healed.
Yes, what's his name, Reed?
Esau Brown. Healing right now, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That the kidney stone will break up and will pass.
Hallelujah.
There would be no surgery. And if there will be a surgery, have to be a surgery, we ask it, oh God, to control the hands,
come
be with the surgeon hand, and be, go before him, and let everything be all right. Father God, we're asking for a quick recovery, even with the passing of the stone. Father God, we're asking for a quick recovery and no complication. In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name. Read right there too, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord's touching your shoulder. Right now, Father, in the name of Lord, I just thank you right now for the anointing right now in this shoulder.
Yes.
Lord, for cartilage in this shoulder right now, Father God, for Reed to do anything he needs to do in the name of Jesus without pain. Father, I just thank you, Lord, for rebuilding this shoulder right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, that there'll be no pain, there'll be no restriction of him being able to work or use this shoulder no more from this day forward, Father. We just thank you for that right now, Lord. You are the God. You are the creator. You are the healer, Lord. And we just thank you by faith right now, Lord, that Reed receives this touch, Lord, in Jesus' name. There'll be no arthritis in his body. I said there'll be no arthritis in his body in the name of Jesus, be it unto you. Be it unto you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Thank God to be here because I haven't told nobody about this.
Thank you, Jesus.
I was suffering with this shoulder. I never asked for prayer on that.
You got it, bro.
Now, you know, God spoke to him. So spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's just good to be obedient to the Spirit.
To glory be God. Hallelujah. This is God's people. We're God's people. You ain't got to know it all. Just love God. And it's done, Reed. It's done. It's not by works. We ain't boasting about it, but we thanking God about it. Amen. Make sure we're getting this on camera. Ha ha. Come on. We got another healing testimony. Come on, we can just put that on the devil's feet. Come on. Stomp, stomp. Another devil defeated. Another devil arthritis defeated in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Ain't God good? I just humble myself and thank him that he would use somebody like us to bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Tell you what, you build God's house, he keep your house working, man. Working, won't he? Won't he, Frankie? God's good at building things. Come on. This is who he is. In these end times, we're going to show God. We're going to glorify him. Amen. And he's going to raise us up and put us on in places. Take us places if we'll just continue to bless him and trust him. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's just give God some time. Give him some glory. Hallelujah. It ain't me, oh Lord. It's you. We just thank you, Lord. That's how the church grows, man. Did you hear what's happening on 757 Harris Street? Arthritis. Them people don't have arthritis. How they not have arthritis? Jesus don't have arthritis. Jesus don't have it. Jesus don't have diabetes. Jesus don't have hearts that don't beat right. Jesus. Say yes to Jesus. If you're listening online and you've never said yes to Jesus, I would make a point to say yes today. He'll save you from hell, but also he'll heal your body. He'll fill your pocketbook with coins and Ben Franklin's and them and lots of money. Amen. He wants to bless you. I said he's out to bless you. What are you going to do? Amen. Are you going to trust him today? Are you going to believe him today? We believe in him. We trust him, yes. Man. Yes, Lord.
Our granddaughter, Morgan, went back to talk to this last week. She got a good report.
Another good report.
Another good report on her 6-month schedule now.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
We believe in that 6-month visit she makes next year, she will see in a year.
Hallelujah. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom.
Right, well, we'll see you when you need us.
When you need us, call us. If you need a doctor, you come see me.
That's
but
right.
If don't, you bless, you heal.
Right.
Amen. Amen. It pays where you go to church.
And Creed's doing exceptionally well.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank God for it.
And just tell them, you say, just give God the glory. We thank people like Colette that met you in a mall. Why? The church being the church outside the building. Amen. That's how the fire spreads. If somebody gets on fire and starts breathing, you know, starts talking about Jesus. Because you blow on a fire, it gets hotter and hotter. Come on. Keep talking about Jesus. He gets bigger and bigger. See, in other words, a lot of times, sometimes we look at the problem like a pair of binoculars and we just magnify the problem instead of magnifying God. See, we got to determine we're going to quit magnifying the problem. We're going to magnify God. Why? Because he wants to bless us. Amen. Amen. That's right. Glory to God. Be it unto you according to your faith, Elaine. Eyes be healed. Eyes be healed in Jesus' name. Eyes see clearly. Whatever test they have to take, Lord, passed the test, Elaine, in Jesus' name. You've passed the test. Amen. Because Jesus passed the test. Jesus was broken. We broke the bread. His body was broken so your eyes could be whole. Be whole in Jesus' name. Amen. Be whole. Let's go from being healed to be whole. I took that series home from Brother Copeland. I think it's a 4-part DVD. Make me whole. I need to listen to it. Hear his voice. I need to be listening to it. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Ain't God good? All the time. Let's stand. Thank you, Jesus. I tell you what, Reed, I just think you just need to dismiss us or you need to preach the rest of the sermon. You choose. You choose. Glory.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Our Father, most gracious God, we just come, Father God, once again for your word. Father God, we thank you, Father God, for loving us and throwing your strong protection around us. Father God, and as we leave this place, but never your presence, Father God, and we go to our very destination, we find all well. Now may the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, brother.
Thank you for joining us today at Word of Faith Worship Center. I pray God's grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of our Lord Jesus Christ. And if you do not know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, then according to Romans 10, 8 through 10, the word is nigh unto thee, in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach, that if you will confess with your mouth Jesus as your Lord and believe that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. For with the heart you believe unto righteousness, and with your mouth confession is made unto salvation. We would ask you today to simply say, yes, I believe this, and I say yes to Jesus. Now, if you just received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we would encourage you to get into a good church. Our church is located at 757 Harris Street, Northwest, Concord, North Carolina, 28025. And you can also find us on the internet at wordoffaithworshipcenter.org or wofwc.org. We hope to see you soon. Blessings.